Hello, Daizan here from Zenways. We've been looking a little bit at the Buddha's Eightfold Path, the scheme, the unfolding sequence of elements that he laid out as a practice framework. So this session, we're going to look a little bit at the second step in the Eightfold Path, right intention. Human beings are very intention-led animals. If you look around you right now, probably nothing that you can see within the room you're in, or indeed outside, probably none of it has been untouched by human intention. It might well be that human intention is one of the most powerful forces at work on this planet that we find ourselves today. And this element of human intention is perhaps getting stronger as time goes by. So this powerful force of human intention can be harnessed in furtherance of our practice, of our cultivation, our development, or not. You do come across, you may well have come across yourself, teachers, people who say that intention is actually problematic on the path of practice and development, that we should strive to be without intention. I don't really agree with that, particularly in the early stages. I think it's tremendously important to actually crystallize our intention, to bring it to a point of focus. What do I mean by this? Well, let me give you an example. John, one of our practitioners here, he's retired now, but a few years ago, he was working as a contractor. I remember he came to talk to me in probably October one year. He knew he wasn't going to get a new contract until the new year, so he had a period of time, a couple of months, 3 months perhaps, which he could really devote pretty much full time to his practice. And he wanted to make the best use out of this quite unforeseen opportunity. So we kind of sat down and looked into what was his intention for this period. How could we crystallize this? What did he want to get out of this? What was going to be for him the ideal use of this time and the focus that would bring that practice to a sort of a point? Well, we talked about outcomes, energies, possibilities, all this kind of thing. And we boiled it down to the intention, kensho by Christmas. That's what he decided to go for. He got it the next day. When we turn our intention and our attention in a certain direction, we tend to get it. So in terms of our right intention, can we bring together, can we crystallize an intention towards awakening, towards greater liberation, greater awakening and freedom within our life? Now, each person has their intention. In the Zen tradition, this is crystallized frequently, and you'll see this in many of the old masters, in terms of a vow or a series of vows. For example, there's quite an eminent Zen master a couple of hundred years back in our background called Master Satori from Japan. And Satori's vows are very famous. He put a lot of energy into composing his vows. And then he would bring these to mind. Now, what would your vow be? The shorter, the crisper, the clearer you can make it, the better, in my experience. Now, this can be something that actually is there for your whole life. And we have, for example, the overarching bodhisattva vow. However innumerable beings may be, I vow to save them all. Now, how's that going to manifest? Well, one of the things about a vow and intention like that is you're not going to run out of stuff to do. It's going to keep you, as it were, going. It's going to keep you on the path. But it's also totally possible, and I think quite a smart move, to have more targeted, perhaps even more short-term vows. What are you going to be focused on? Maybe now, maybe over the next month, the next 3 months, the next year. If you can boil that right down to a phrase that every time you sit down to practice or you begin your walking meditation, anytime you've got a practice opportunity opening up, if you can, as it were, bring to mind your vow and then start the practice, it's quite extraordinary what can manifest. This element of intention, and intention in this case towards awakening, is tremendously powerful. Another perspective on this is, in the Zen school, we come from what's called the Mahayana school of Buddhism. The great, or the boundless vehicle, would be one way of characterizing this approach. In this approach, there's a conception that the whole universe is undergoing a process of waking up. It might be slow, but nevertheless, the whole universe is moving towards greater awakeness, greater aliveness, greater liberation. When you make your vow, when you, as it were, establish your right intention, one way of thinking about what you're doing is you're aligning your individual sense of things with this universal waking up process. And this is very powerful. Changes your alignment with the world. In a sense, it changes the world that you're living in. So perhaps it might be time well spent to think about your intention, your deepest heart's wish. What are you really here for? What, for you, is the fulfillment of your deepest sense of the purpose of this life experience and life energy that you're manifesting right now? What is your right intention?